Well, among the projects that the Conference of Egyptian Entities Abroad Expatriates is interested in is the issue of developing the Egyptian countryside. So to shed more light on this, we have the pleasure to have this phone with Dr. Khaled Abdel Halim, Deputy Director of Upper Egypt Local Development Program. Good afternoon, Dr. Abdel Halim.
Good afternoon.
Dr. Abdel Halim, could you give us an idea about the projects concerning the Upper Egypt or the developing issue in the Egyptian countryside?
Yes, sure. The Upper Egypt Local Development Program started in 2018 as part of the attention given by the political leadership, President Sisi, to the development of lagging behind regions, and especially Upper Egypt. The program is implemented in cooperation between the Egyptian government and the World Bank.
Yes.
The assistance from the World Bank was requested by President Sisi in 2015 in his first visit to Washington and his meeting with the head of the World Bank. And accordingly, this program was designed to address the multidimensional poverty in Upper Egypt through multiple interventions that aim not only at improving infrastructure and services like sanitation, water, health, education, and so on, and roads, but also to improve the competitiveness of the Upper Egypt region and its attractiveness to investment and the creation of jobs, job opportunities in Upper Egypt. So it's the most comprehensive development program that has been directed to Upper Egypt since 3 decades, actually. And out of this program came also another very important presidential program or initiative, Haya Karima or Decent Life Initiative.
Yes.
That was directed generally to the poorest villages in phase one. Most of these poorest villages existed in Upper Egypt already. It became also the second biggest program directed to the development of Upper Egypt. And in its second phase, 700 billion Egyptian pounds are going to be spent over 3 years, scaling up the intervention from villages to the whole districts within these poor villages exist, to make sure that also the services are provided in an efficient way and well connected, especially between also cities and villages and so on.
Yes. Dr. Abdel Halim, what is the coordination between the project and the Decent Life Initiative?
Mm-hmm. The good thing that both initiatives are spearheaded by the Prime Minister. So we report to the Prime Minister as the head of a steering committee of the Upper Egypt Program, and also the Rural Development Program is also under the Prime Minister office, but both are executed through the Ministry of Local Development. So we exist, our office is Ministry of Local Development, and under the leadership of the Minister of Local Development.
Yes.
General Mahmoud Shaarawy.
Yes.
Is ensuring that we coordinate very closely between the two programs. I'll give you one example.
Yes.
Since the infrastructure and services are going to be handled in rural areas by the Rural Development Program, we.
Yes.
Focus our investments in the coming 2 years in the Upper Egypt Program in cities, in urban development, and in competitiveness, like improving the infrastructure in industrial zones, the support of cluster development and handicrafts, and so on. So we.
Yes.
Made sure to complement the interventions of the two programs together.
Yes. Dr. Abdel Halim, now the Decent Life Initiative that is launched by President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi is expected to extend for 3 years. Is it going parallel in coordination with the Egypt Local Development Program? For.
Yes,
Upper
exactly.
Egypt, of course.
Yes.
Is it.
Yes.
Going parallel?
Yes, they will go in parallel.
Yes.
It's here, I will tell you also a very important point of complementarity here.
Yes.
That the trunk in investments in infrastructure and services will come from the rural development presidential initiative, Haya Karima.
Yes. But decent
then
life,
our program,
yes.
Decent life, yes.
Yes.
But our program is not, in Upper Egypt program, is not only focusing on urban development and other physical improvements. It's mainly focusing on the improvement of performance of local administration, on the development of systems, of planning, of operation and maintenance, of citizen participation, of transparency and disclosure of information. So this actually makes sure that after the 3 years of the Decent Life initiative, when we have uplifted the standard of living and the services in rural areas,
yes,
in Upper Egypt, then the local administration is competent enough to continue the development process and to continue to engage citizens and private sector and civil society in the development efforts that will come thereafter.
Yes, I thank you very much for your valuable information and for your time, Dr. Khaled Abdel Halim, Deputy Director of Upper Egypt Local Development Program. Thank you very much for joining us. A short break, ladies and gentlemen, and I'm going to be back with you.